winner, James Reynolds, has won cash and prizes totaling $21,830. Today, one of our contestants could win a dining room, a Rockwell lithograph, a diamond ring, or a cruise to the Mexican Riviera, and continue a journey towards a fortune in cash and prizes, including this Camaro, and $50,000 in cash. In total, over $100,000 on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Well, thank you. Nice to have you with us. And we're delighted to have you join us for Sale of the Century. I hope you're with us on our last show. We crowned a new champion, and his very first crack at the winner's board, well, why don't you see for yourself?
You got the car! Really? Congratulations. Come on up here.
Thank you.
Wow, you got it. Congratulations.
Brand new car with one crack at the winner's board. Let's welcome him back. James Reynolds. Hi, James.
Hi, Jim. How you doing?
Good.
Good.
Did you have an idea before the numbers you wanted to pick or something? You just right away, with 20 numbers up there, made the right combination.
I knew all along which numbers I was going to pick.
Well, it worked very well for you. Yes. We congratulate you again on the car. Are you ready to have at it again?
Sure thing.
All right, good luck. Here to introduce the challengers, Summer Bartholomew. Hello there, Summer. That's nice when somebody hits a car. That is a great way to finish up a day.
Yeah.
Who'd you bring us today?
She is a member of the Sierra Club from Rancho Palos Verdes, California. Let's meet Alice Richardson.
Hello there, Alice.
And he has a unique T-shirt collection originally from the Bronx, New York. Help welcome Robert Emmer.
Hello there, Robert. See you a little later with some bargain summer. Thank you. Robert, you have a unique T-shirt collection?
Yes, I do, Jim. I have over 600 rock and roll T-shirts that I started collecting when I was in college.
600, my goodness.
Yes.
What's your favorite?
My favorite was the first one I got, which was the David Bowie, Ziggy Stardust, Spiders from Mars T-shirt from the first tour.
That goes back to his very first album there, right?
Yes, still hasn't been washed nor worn.
Oh, good. In that order. Nice to have you here, Robert. And Alice, you are a member of the Sierra Club.
Yes, Jim. We enjoy backpacking and camping, and one of our most adventurous trips was camping during a snowstorm on a mountaintop.
I would imagine that would be. Were you planning on that, or did it just happen?
The snow was a surprise.
The snow? Yeah, I guess it would be.
But we enjoyed it, especially surviving.
Well, indeed. Yeah. Nice to have you here as well.
Thank
$20 starts all three players off. Let's get into the match with this. This box office champ battled a Russian Superman. James?
Sylvester Stallone.
In the fourth installment of his movie saga, you're right, Sylvester Stallone played Rocky, and you've got five for the correct answer. What handy device comes in the following varieties? Bobby, safety, and straight. Robert?
What is pin?
Pin. I give up. What is
pin?
Pin is exactly right, Robert. You get 5 to 25. On what object would you find the safety warning close cover before striking? James?
On matches.
That's right. Matches, matchbook cover, and you've got 5 going to 30. According to the old saying, only two things in life are certain. Death is one, James.
Taxes is the other.
Yes, indeed. And the champion of 35. Talk about instant bargains. This little fairy tale boy sold his cow for 5 beans. Robert.
Who was Jack Spratt?
No, that's he was with the fat there. No, Jack. It was Jack, but Jack and the Beanstalk. Different Jack. I'm sorry about that, Robert. You lose 5 for the incorrect answer, down to 20. And talking about instant bargains, it's time now for an instant bargain. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. James, you have a $15 lead over the challengers and the opportunity to buy these.
James, we've got a bright idea for you. Authentic pure crystal lamps imported from Europe by Crystal Clear Industries. Each piece is hand-cut and individually signed. Suddenly, everything is crystal clear, and it's normally priced at $400. But today on Sale of the Century, the year's for only $6.
Beautiful lamps.
Beautiful.
$6 for $400 worth of beautiful lamps.
I'm all for upgrading my apartment.
Well, they certainly would upgrade it. Well, I don't know if they'd upgrade or not, but they certainly would be lovely in the apartment. I'm not going to put your apartment down right away, but I will tell you this. You can have them for $6. You'd still have a $9 lead, and I'll give you $100 for the electricity bill as well. $500 bargain for $6. Going once, going twice, and no sale.
I had visions of them breaking.
Of course, yes.
But they're beautiful.
Hanging on to the $15 lead. We're back with this. In the classic Walt Disney movie, Cruella de Vil James?
101 Dalmatians.
Well, you know those heavy movies there, right? Those art films. Cruella de Vil, Dognap, how many Dalmatians? 101 is right. James goes to 40. We usually describe someone who was young and innocent as a little wet behind... James?
Behind the ears.
Yeah, I love the way they worded it, what part of his anatomy. The ears is right, yes, and James gets another 5. What would your wife do with her pedal pushers? James?
She'd wear them.
That's right. They're pants. And James to 50. Strong segment for the champion. And now we play the fame game. For control of the fame game board, players buzz in when you know a famous person. I was born in Wisconsin in 1919. I was given the names of Vladzu Valentino, but Alice?
Rudolph Valentino?
No, incorrect. Took a chance, did not pay off. You stay at 20, though. You're playing for control of the board. However, you're out of the rest of the question. We'll clear it. Continue for the gentleman. But for several years, I was billed as Walter Buster Keys. Robert?
Buster Keaton?
No. It's picked up on Valentino and Buster, but no, you're wrong. And James gets the rest of the question all to himself. Yes, I once played Three Little Fishies as an encore, and the audience responded so well to my winks and smiles, I kept such antics in my act. My outlandish clothes cost a fortune. On my piano, there's always a candelabra. It's an idea I borrowed from a movie about Frédéric Chopin. He's smiling happily. Yes, James?
I'll stop you. Liberace.
Yes, indeed. Liberace it is. You have the rest of the question.
Sure.
Yeah, his real name, Vladzu Valentino, which probably, that threw Alice, and then the Walter Buster Keys threw Robert. James came through. Where's the $10 money card?
Behind the one.
And the lights are flashing, and if you can stop those flashing lights on the $10, we'll add it to your score. You've already got a big lead. Are you going to add another 10? Good luck.
I hope to.
Oh, you went right next to it. Number 4 gives him what?
Video cassettes. A selection of video cassettes, including Jane Fonda's Workout and Workout Challenge. And Lyle Alzado's No Sweat, an excellent way to get in shape. From Carl Lorimar Home Video.
That's $300 worth of video cassettes. Congratulations. They're yours to keep, no matter how you finish in the game. And the champion's got a pretty good lead. Back to the game right after this.
Where was the champagne? If you guess number 5, you're right. You've won another episode of Classic Concentration. Tonight, starting at 2 on Buzzer.
Our champion, James Reynolds, looking for a second crack at the winner's board, and he's got a $30 lead already over the challengers. Come on, Robert, now. He's got to get going. According to the old wives' tale, that what seafood should only be eaten in months, James?
Oysters.
With an R in their names. Oysters is exactly right. Good anticipation. Drop you to 55. Name the benevolent organization for which the letters SPCA stand. Robert?
Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals.
Very nicely done. Robert, back on the plus side now at 25. Yes. What color is your hair if people call you a towhead? Alice?
Red.
No. Towhead is blonde. They also accept white, but no blonde. Sorry about that, Alice. You lose 5 down to, I think, Carrot Top would fit the red there. Down to 15. Give me the name of the cape that lies at the southern tip of Africa. Robert?
Cape Horn.
No, that's the Cape of Good Hope. Good Hope. Took a chance. Lost 5 on that. Back down to 20. And James doesn't mind at all because he's really got some breathing space. James, you're at 55. Robert's in second place at 20. You can easily afford to buy this.
James, if you have a king's ransom in jewels, protect them with an electronic safe. It's made of sturdy steel and can be bolted to the floor. Program your own six-digit combination. It's designed with a special electronic safety device from the price of his toys. And it's normally priced at $795. But today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $10.
Hey, well, that's a nice thing. That's a terrific thing. You look more like Prince Valiant. That guy. I love Prince Valiant. Oh, he should have shaved your legs before you put the tights on, no? James, $795 safe.
That's a great thing to have.
That really is. That's an awfully nice thing. That is a very useful item. It would cost you only $10. And with your big lead, you would still have a big lead. You'd have a $25 lead if you bought it. But as an inducement, you wouldn't buy the last time. Doggone it, I like to sell things. Summer's talking all about it. We want to sell it. I'll give you $200 in cash. The safe and $200 in cash for $10. You'd still have a $25 lead. Going once.
Should I buy it?
Going twice. Going to buy the safe with the cash to put something in it. All right. That's a great advantage when you get that big lead. You can easily afford to buy. He buys, cost him $10, down to $45, and still a $25 lead. From what kind of animal do we get Boston butts, hocks, Alice?
Pig.
Pigs are right, and Alice back to the $20 mark, yes, indeed. On what kind of table would you play snooker? James?
A pool table.
Pool table is exactly right. James gets five to ten back. Where would you be visiting if you were strolling through the Imbrium Basin or lounging beside the Sea of Tranquility? James?
You'd be on the moon.
You would indeed, and James back to the $55 mark as he just beats Robert to the buzzer. When humans breathe, we take in oxygen. We breathe out. Robert?
Carbon dioxide.
You got it, and you've got another five going to 25. The American businessman who made most of his $4 billion fortune in oil was J. Paul. Alice?
Getty.
Getty is right, and Alice ties Robert for second place at 25. That's good. Challenger's starting to get on track there. Well, talking about J. Paul Getty, when he was asked for his formula for success, he offered these three pieces of advice. Rise early, work late, and strike oil. We'll be right back.
Concentrate.
Let's take a look at two more parts of our puzzle.
For that new car. Here's the puzzle.
For heaven's sake.
Well, for heaven's sake, yeah. Ready to play?
Back to Welcome back to James at 55, Alice and Robert both at 25, and back to the fame game with another money card being added up there on the board. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in 1921 with the middle name Herschel and grew up to be a national hero. During World War II, I flew 59 missions in the Pacific Theater. During the Korean War, I shot down 3 communist planes. In 1959, I was chosen for the Mercury space program. 3 years later, I was the first American to orbit the Earth. I became a United States Senator. Robert.
John Glenn.
John Glenn is right. Yes, indeed. Right. He's done a lot in his life. Robert, you've got control. Where's that $15 money card,
sir? Behind that, too.
15. Two of them to shoot for. Good luck. Run right by it. I hope you have something nice behind number 5.
A mantle clock. Michael C. Fiener's 1810 Americana mantle clock. With Westminster quarter hour striking movement in a genuine walnut hand rubbed case. Furnished by the Michael C. Fiener Company.
Well over $400 clock. Yours to keep, no matter how you finish in the game. And back with all 3 of you now in this for $5. In what nation will you find the city of Kimberley, known as the diamond capital of the world? Robert.
In Africa.
More, please.
Kenya.
No, I'm sorry. South Africa. South Africa. You were on the right track. We gave you the chance to get it. You did not. You lose 5. Name the animal used to describe the stock market when prices... James?
A bull?
When prices are rising? Yes, that's bull. Oh, you were lucky on that one. Got another 5. Which American president helped work out the Camp David Agreement with Begin and Sadat? Alice?
Carter.
Carter is right, and Alice to 30. But again, an instant bargain. And James, you stretch that lead out again. This time, you've got a $30 lead, and we've TV. Got something very lovely. Look at this.
James, if the question is TV or not TV, here's the answer. A 25-inch console TV with a built-in MTS decoder and detachable infrared remote control, plus direct audio and video input jacks on a swivel base, furnished by Sharp. And it's normally priced at $999. But today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $15.
Great prize. Great prize.
You put something I really want up there.
What's that, James?
That's something I really want.
Oh, it's beautiful. $999, great TV. You would still have a $15 lead if you bought it. And again, I'll give you $200 to go with it. Over a $1,000 bargain for 15 bucks. Going once, going twice. He wants that color TV. Join the color TV and the cash as well. We knock it off your score, still a $15 lead, but that's only 3 questions over Alice. We'll find out how it all comes out after this. Nice try. Enjoy that. Back to the match. Always a happy moment when a returning champion comes back to join us. If you've been with us, you remember Rocky Brown won over $50,000 in cash and prizes. Rocky stopped in because he came down to pick up his car. That's why. You like the car, Rock? Good. Enjoy. We're enjoying a good match here. James at 45, Alice at 30, and Robert at 20. What biblical king wed a woman named Bathsheba? Robert?
Solomon?
No. David wed Bathsheba, and you lose five. In 1968, he commanded Apollo 8, but today he's better known as the president of Eastern Airlines. He is Robert...
Glenn.
No. Frank, I was going to give you Borman, and you lose another five. Who was Ginger Rogers' dashing dance partner, Alice?
Fred Astaire.
Gotta be Fred Astaire, and Alice goes to 35, within 10 of James. And with $10 separating the two of them, all three money cards, including a big one worth 25, will be up on the board. Famous person. When I was born in Bengal, India, I was named Eric Arthur Blair. When I became a novelist, I adopted my pen name, now known to millions. My early books include A Clergyman's Daughter, which concerns poverty, Homage to Catalonia, about my experiences as a soldier. Two of my books are more familiar to the public, Animal Farm. Robert.
Orwell.
That's right, George Orwell it is. All right, you got it,
money
Robert.
Card. Come
Take
on.
That $25 money card.
Behind the three.
Well, right. If you can hit that
Top
25,
row.
You'll
Come
be right
on.
In there. Good luck. Way down the other corner, number eight, and he gets...
Parquet flooring. Hartco solid oak parquet flooring. A beautiful oak floor designed to install yourself with a cushion foam backing for your added comfort. Furnished by Hartco Parquet.
Almost $400 worth of flooring, but I know he wanted that $25 money card. We finish up the game now with the speed round, so may I have 60 seconds on the clock, please. It is James at 45, Alice at 35, Robert at 10, but a lot of questions as we start the speed round. Now, what mighty animal is the largest member of the ape family? Robert.
Gorilla.
Right. What mathematical process would you use to produce a sum? Robert.
Addition.
Right. Name the comedian whose funny films include The Jerk. James.
Steve Martin.
Right. Name the chubby infant who was the Roman god of love. Robert.
Valentine.
Wrong. What can't you do if you have insomnia? James.
You can't sleep.
Right. In the expression, to the victor belong. Alice.
Spoils.
Right. Which southern state has its capital at Frankfurt? Robert.
Virginia.
Wrong. What instrument is played by jazz great Miles Davis? Robert.
Trumpet.
Right. The explorer Balboa discovered what great body? Robert.
Pacific Ocean.
Right. What is the main ingredient in meringue? James.
I don't know. Lemon.
Right. Wrong. What holiday is celebrated on the third Sunday in June?
Time.
Name the capital of the Irish Republic. Alice.
Dublin.
Right. Who was John F. Kennedy's vice president? James.
Lyndon Johnson.
Right. What liquid is made up of hemoglobin? And what time is up? And James has won it. And if he had missed that last one, we would have had a tie. I believe he had a tie on the last one. Back to the champion in just a moment. First of all, the holiday celebrated on the third Sunday in June is Father's Day. No one wanted to try that. And the main ingredient in meringue is egg whites. Egg whites. The capital, Frankfurt, that is Kentucky. And the chubby infant, the Roman god of love, is Cupid. Got to say goodbye to Robert and Alice. And, well, Robert, you did quite well with the mantle clock, the flooring, the cash in front of you, $820. Thank you for joining us. Alice, unfortunately, didn't pick up anything along the way, but you almost took over that championship. We congratulate you on a very well-played match. But James Reynolds gets his second crack at the winner's board. Come on, James. Yeah, if you had missed that last one, we would have had a tie. Yeah, you had a $5 lead when you buzzed in on that last one, so congratulations.
Thank
now,
you.
A lot of new things up there on the board, including a ski package. There is a beautiful diamond ring, very, very exotic telescope. And if you make the right combination, you could have this great Mexican cruise. Jay?
Set sail for the good life on a cruise to the Mexican Riviera. You and a friend will leave Los Angeles for Princess Cruises' magnificent 7-day vacation. Sail to the golden Mexican Riviera in luxury. Sumptuous cuisine and dazzling entertainment await you. Furnished by Princess Cruises. And this prize is worth $4,000.
Well, that would be lovely.
That would be great.
It's up here on the board. You know how to do it. You make a match, that prize is yours, James. You do it very well with just two numbers. You got a car the last time. What are you going to get this time? Good luck. Start picking.
Let's see. How about number five?
Number five, starting off with diamond ring. Find the match for that. Over $2,000 ring is yours.
How about number 10?
Number 10. And a China gift certificate, $2,000 gift certificate, as a matter of fact.
Okay, number 17.
Number 17. He's looking for a match, and he gets 3,000.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how about number 6?
Number 6. Is that a match? 10,000. Bouncing around with the money now.
Let's see number 4.
Number 4. Ski package. All over the place.
Okay. Let's have number 15.
Number 15 and 15, win card. Well, now we're going to have a match. The next thing you pick is an automatic match. What is it?
How about number 11?
Number 11. For the win, James gets dining room furniture. Beautiful furniture. You will enjoy it. And Jay Stewart's going to tell you all about it, Jay.
And good taste to your dining with this dining room grouping from Italy. A table and four side chairs. Lovely antique reproduction of authentic country French pieces in bleached pines and selected hardwoods from California Furniture Galleries. And this prize is worth $2,777.
Beautiful furniture, it's yours. Sit down. Yes, indeed. Let the man have his furniture. You get comfortable, and we will be back with this fine champion right after this commercial timeout. Enjoy.
It will.
Just like Nancy Reagan. Hey.
$27,101. You'll meet two new challengers next time on Sale of the Century. Bye for now.
Bye-bye.
All prices
prices or manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. Sale of the Century stars Jim Carrey. This is Jay Stewart speaking. Sale of the Century is a Red Strandy production.